The standard water tank for the Aussie Swag Campers Ultra D model, or all the models actually, is 195 litres, which is a massive tank. It's the, as far as I know, it's the largest single water tank in a hard floor rear fold camper trailer in Australia. But we do have the option of having a secondary water tank as well, which is 65 litres. So a total of 60 litres is a massive amount of water. And the way it's set up here, this particular trailer has that set up, is that the two tanks are plumbed separately. They don't join each other, but you can switch between them quite easily using a three-way valve here. And I'll just show you how that works. So you've got your shower rose here, which is on a trigger. You have your flick mixer here, which you use that to adjust your water temperature. And you have two valves here. The top valve chooses your water source in terms of tank one or tank two. Tank one's the big one, 195 litres. Tank two is a small one. So we've got it on tank one at the moment. The bottom valve here chooses your water source in terms of either from the tanks, either one or two, or bypassing the tanks, the external source. So we'll leave them on tank and open up the trigger and we're pumping out of tank one. Change the valve over, pumping out of tank two. That's quite simple. If you want to save tank two, for example, for bore water, you can use that for showering and then shower in your tank two water. Then when you've finished your showering, change it back to one, and you can cook and have your drinking water from tank one. There is a secondary valve, obviously, I've mentioned, which bypasses both tanks. So if we put it to E, we're now pumping out of the external source, which is whatever this hose is connected to. In this case, it's a bucket. Now, most people would have it connected to a jerry can. Now, pumping out of the external source has several advantages. In fact, I almost exclusively shower from an external source, mainly because of children. If you have a see-through plastic jerry can, for example, you can give that to your kids and tell them that's how much water you've got, so they're not likely to end up with shampoo in their hair and they're running out of water. Because it's very easy, pumping at 12 litres a minute, even a 65 litre tank can be emptied in 5 minutes. So it's best to pump out an external source for water management reasons when you're showering. The other advantage is that, this is your flick mixer here, and to adjust your temperature. Now, like at home, you've always got a couple of litres or more of cold water in your pipes, and also it takes a while as you're adjusting your temperature to get it where you like it. Now, if you're pumping out of your tanks, that is just going onto the floor, being wasted. If you're pumping out of an external source, even a jerry can, you can have the nozzle down in your jerry can entrance, and you can adjust the temperature. And when you've got it to your liking, that's when you can start showering. So you haven't wasted any water whatsoever. Now, water and power are the two things you run out of when you're camping in remote locations. So having that, even a couple of litres, it makes a difference in the long run, especially when you've got four people showering. You know, that's a fifth person's shower, really, 8 litres. So that's the advantage of having the external water source. Now, there is a third valve, and that is located up here. Now, I'll just turn that on and you can hear it. So what that is now doing, it's pumping from this external source and pumping into the tank. So that third valve changes the water direction from supply to fill. So we've got it on tank two, so at the moment we're filling tank two from this pipe here. Change it to tank one, we're now filling tank one from that supply. And as you just heard, it emptied the water in the bucket pretty quickly. When you do use this mode though, it is very important, so we're filling from here, is to have the water tank caps off. Otherwise, the pressure build up, the air will have nowhere to go. It can pop the fittings in the lines somewhere, and you can get leaks. So you just have to remember to take those caps off. So the advantage of that is when you're camping long-term in some kind of, especially beach locations, you set up for a month or so, you're going to, a couple of weeks, you're going to empty your water tanks. And you don't want to move your tank down to the local water supply, obviously. So what you can do is have your car with the jerry cans in the back of the car when you're driving past Yurong or wherever you're camped. If you camp at Fraser, for example, you can fill your jerry cans up, bring them back, fill them at 12 litres a minute, fill the tanks from the jerry cans, and then you have your empties back in the car, go back down when you're driving past, fill them up, and eventually you can fill your tanks back up again. Now that's particularly useful because otherwise you're trying to fill by lifting your jerry cans up and getting it through the filler, which is almost impossible. So without that option, you're really having to live out of jerry cans after a couple of weeks, which is not very convenient. So the way this is set up, you can choose your tank, you can choose your water supply, you can fill from an external water supply. It's very practical, very simple to use, and prolongs your stay in remote locations. Right, so we have a close-up now of those valves. This is tank one. Tank 2, the smaller one, external source, tank. So pumping out of the tank, you need the arrow pointed to T, and that'll be coming out of the smaller tank, that's coming out of the larger tank. Arrow pointed to the E is bypassing both tanks and pumping directly out of your external water source, which is this. Arrow pointed to the E, and this valve on the top, open, that is pumping out of external water source to tank 1 or pumping out of external water source to tank 2. Just empty the bucket, pumps at 12 litres a minute, it's pretty quick. So the water tank caps are located on the fill points are located on the driver's side of the camper up the front, right conveniently next to the shower, so you don't have to go far to take the cap off if you want to fill. And you just push it in anti-clockwise and remove the cap. So the way we've configured them, the cap on filler point at the rear is the rear tank, which is the big one, 195 litres. The filler point on the front is the front tank, which is a small one, 65 litres. So it's fairly self-explanatory, not hard to remember.